to be talking about a little project that the Sussex County fruit growers helped support financially, along with Adams County Nursery and Apple Hill Farm and the New Hampshire fruit growers. So with that, Jeremy, I'm going to turn it over to you and Tom.
All right. Thank you, George, and welcome, Tom. Thank you very much for being here with us tonight. We're very happy to have you. I'll just start out as well by offering up my thanks again to the Essex County fruit growers, Chuck and Diane at Apple Hill Farm, and everyone at Adams County Nursery for supplying the trees, and the support of the New Hampshire Fruit Growers Association for this as well. So the trees that we have here, they're all planted at Apple Hill Farm. Those were planted, the majority of them were planted in May of 2018 with one follow-up variety that we just couldn't get in year one that we got in the ground in 2019. Just to show everyone kind of the way the blocks are laid out, these are the varieties included. And so for those who have been to Apple Hill, you know, you can imagine going up the hill, and on the left-hand side going up the hill, that's the western side of the orchard, and call that the western block. And so in that block, these are the varieties that are included, and we're going to hear a lot more about each of these varieties as we go through. So two rows of each, we have around 33 varieties, I believe it is, set in the orchard. And then if you are going up the hill to the right-hand side, that's the eastern block. Got another list of varieties here, quite a few included, including kind of come up some of the standards like Red Haven that are included, that it's interesting to kind of, as we go through, compare those, you know, bloom dates, and as we move along, pay attention to those harvest dates and how they line up with standard variety, you know, that we all know like Red Haven. Okay, and so Tom, I want to get your input here. What we've done, as you know, is we've gone through and we intended to have everybody there as a twilight meeting walking around the orchard, but we weren't able to do that. And so George was able to go out and take photos of each variety. And so we wanted to go through these slides and talk about the varieties themselves, and hoping you can give some real commentary on that. And then I've added some notes about bloom dates and some of the observations that I noted throughout this part of the season up to this point. Tom, if you want to comment at all on Buenos.
Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
Can you hear me, Jeremy? You can?
Yep.
Well, Buenos is one of our earliest flats. It's around Red Haven season, and it's semi-cling, but one of the benefits of it is it's actually a red-skinned, yellow-fleshed. And one of the benefits is that it picks easy. It has an abscission layer. A lot of the flat peaches tear when you harvest them.
Sorry, Tom, we lost a little bit of that last part of what you said.
One of the attributes of the Buenos selections is that it has an abscission layer, which harvests easier. It will not tear when you pick the fruit. A lot of your flat peaches have that fault. Okay.
All right, and so you can see here, dates on those. We're at pink at around April 21st. On that variety, full bloom around May 5th, and we did have a pretty heavy bloom on this variety this year, and most of those buds came through without too much winter kill, which we were happy to see. And then, so Galaxy, you can see here, bloom dates on that a little bit later, 428, 5-5 on full bloom. On this variety, we did see a good bit of bud damage this year, and we were a little bit lighter on the bloom this time around.
Jeremy, the Galaxy is more tender than quite the other flats. One of its faults is that the fruit's almost too big. It averages 3.5 to 3 inches in diameter.
Okay, so Tom, as we go through, if when we get to a variety, I'll let you go first and kind of describe that variety and your comments on that, and then I'll talk about my observations this year.
Good. I'd go on to the next slide then.
You see Saturn?
I don't see Saturn, but I can talk about Saturn there. Saturn is probably our most popular flat peach. It's red-skinned, excellent, super sweet variety, and probably our number one seller. It's been a variety that's been around. It was introduced to New Jersey. And initially picked up by Stark Brothers. But we have, one of the things I will say about it is difficult to pick because it has a tendency, if you let it get too overripe, it tears very easily. So what I suggest doing is harvest it in the morning when the fruit is cool and don't let the fruit get overripe.
Okay, Tom, we're still once in a while getting a delay. So I wonder sometimes, although we would much prefer to see you while we're listening to you, sometimes if you stop your video, that helps with the sound. So I'm wondering if that might fix the problem for us.
I think part of it is too, is I have a weak connection here, so.
Okay.
I can, but cut I can your stop video the video. For you. I can cut your video for you.
Okay.
We'll keep doing our best here. So bloom dates on this around five for full bloom. This is a really pretty variety in bloom, light pink petals, very showy. We had a heavy bloom this year, and hopefully going to have a good crop. Here taking some measurements of the little fruit as they're setting up. And so it's nice to see, looks like it's going to be a pretty decent crop of Saturn this year.
One comment I would make, Jeremy, is through winter freezes quite well.
It makes it through winter freezes quite well?
It does, yes.
Yeah, and we certainly saw that this year. Here it is in bloom, and we had a great bloom on it. Nice light pink flowers on that. And get some nicely shaped trees there as well. Okay, so next variety we have is Tangos.
Tangos is a yellow skin, yellow flesh variety. Again, studies have shown it seems to be quite bud hardy. Negative aspects is on rainy summers where we get a lot of precipitation, the fruit has a tendency to crack. But other than that, it's a nice spicy piece of fruit.
Yep, and we saw again, right around that 5-5 full bloom date, a lighter colored bloom. We had a little bit of bud kill, not too bad. And then large showy flowers. And I think this is the only variety that we actually lost a tree on. So we lost one of these, but everything else, we still have all three of each variety that we initially set.
Nectarfest is a selection of nectarine that came out of USDA. And in the trials that we had around the state and other states, one of the things that stood out was that it was extremely bud hardy. Even some years where we lost peaches, we still had Nectarfest. The timing on this is early Red Haven season.
Okay, Avalon.
Avalon is out of Rutgers. It comes in about 2 weeks ahead of of Red Haven for 2.5 weeks ahead. Its parent is Eastern Glow. It has a very good parent. It picks about 4 days after Eastern Glow, but it is very resistant to bacterial leaf spot.
We were again right around 5/5, May 5th for full bloom. We had a good fruit set, large showy flowers, and it looks like we are going to have a good crop on this. One of the things that we're hoping to do, Tom, is COVID may put a crimp in this plan, but we were really hoping to do some taste testing with folks this year. So we're going to have to kind of see whether or not that's a possibility. I hope so, but that's one of the aspects of this study that we're hoping to include this season.
Okay, Brigantine is in Red Haven season, and it's a large nectarine. The flavor on it is somewhat subacid, so it has more of a Western flavor. But a large nectarine for its season, and seems to be quite bud hardy.
That's certainly what we saw this year. These trees have grown like crazy. They've really taken off, and I'm really interested to see what the flavor's like, because it's a nice tree. It seems to be really hardy, and it seems to be quite vigorous. So we've really gotten off to a good start for us.
Going through, taking the pictures, Jeremy, it's, to me, for three trees, it was one of the better ones. Seeing more uniformity in the trees, a lot of good growth to them. You'd have to stay on top of it. I think it could get a little bit hard to control if you leave it go.
Yeah. I should also mention, Tom, that so when these trees were set, George and I had recently spent a day with you traveling around to several farms, and you're showing us, the way you recommend that we train young trees. And, that was somewhere in the neighborhood of knee high for me when we got those trees in. And Chuck Souther, who's and Diane, whose farm this is, Chuck is now calling it the Jeremy Delisle pruning method, but I always blame it on you, Tom. Okay, so can you see Jade up on the screen?
Jade is a rather unique variety in the fact that it is extremely early. It's out of the Riviera, it's out of a French breeding program. But what I like about Jade the most is its extremely large size of fruit. And it's extremely winter hardy and extremely bud hardy. It has one of the largest sized nectarines for the season that I've ever seen. And it is white fleshed.
Yep, and we definitely saw a good fruit set, large showy flowers. It was early in pink, 421 for us. Here it is in bloom. It's a really pretty tree. The trees that we have a really nice shape to them, nice and open, spreading. So I really do. I agree. I like this variety a lot.
Okay, Silver Gem is one of the newer nectarines out of Rutgers. It picks about 12 days ahead of Red Haven. Red Haven for us harvests around the 1st of August. I suspect Red Haven for you, Jeremy, will probably be around the 10th or later of August. It seems to have very good bud hardiness. The fruit size is not as large as Jade.
Okay, and we did see good bud survival here over this past winter. One thing we noticed with this variety, there seems to be a good bit of small wood, which we looked at as a good thing overall, lots of potential fruiting shoots. And so interested to follow this one along as we go too. Interesting tree structure with a lot of smaller shoots, it seems to be. Silver Glow is the next variety.
Silver Globe picks about 5 days after Red Haven. Again, it's another Rutgers selection that has extreme bacterial leaf spot resistance. Fruit is larger than Silver Gem and very flavorful. I believe, though, that it might be a little more tender than Silver Gem.
Yep, and we were kind of in that window there with 421 being pink, still around the 5th of May for full bloom. It was a heavy bloom, but looks like this year we ended up with a lighter fruit set for one reason or another. Emerald is our next variety?
Sure. Emerald is out of the French Riviera breeding program. It's in the same family as Jade. The fruit size is extremely large. Again, it will produce 3.5-inch nectarines. It's white fleshed and has shown good winter survival down in our neck of the woods.
We've seen the same here too. Another variety I'm really interested to follow. Smaller kind of dark flowers, but had good bud survival coming through, and still many of these still around that May 5th date for full bloom.
Does the tree really grow fast on this one, Tom?
Yes, this is a vigorous tree. It normally is, yes.
Okay.
Here it is in full bloom. You can kind of get an idea for the size of the tree, this being its third summer it's going into here. Okay, so spring snow.
Switching gears into early white peaches, spring snow is our earliest white that we pick. It's about 23 days ahead of Red Haven. It's done okay in Massachusetts. It'll be interesting to see how it performs in New Hampshire.
Yeah, so, you know, it looked like this year we're a little light on the bloom. We did see some significant bud kill this year. You know, we had a wacky spring as well, where temperatures got high and then they dropped right back down again for a bit and stayed cool for a long while. But I suspect a lot of that damage happened earlier. But this year, looked a little light, so we'll see how we do in the next couple of years coming through. This is just a photo kind of what I was seeing on some of these varieties, where you'd go through and we'd have, you know, sunflower buds pull through, and then right in between on the same shoot, we'd have some bud kill there, and, you know, they turn gray and basically just don't amount to anything, just end up falling off, so. That's kind of what we were seeing when we see this bud kill and we're talking about bud survival. Okay, Sugar May.
Now, Sugar May for us is one of the oldest Zeiger selections. Quite a few of the whites from Zeiger genetics are subacids, but Sugar May has the traditional white flesh or white acid flavor. It's been an extremely hardy variety and has done well up in through Massachusetts over the years. It's one of our oldest, and we still do quite well with the variety.
And again, we're still in that 5-5 full bloom date range. Large showy flowers on this one, and it'll be interesting to see going forward here with fruit set. We've been a little bit hampered as far as extension in New Hampshire making site visits for the last couple of weeks, but the good news is we just learned today that we have approval to go out and start doing some of those, so I'm excited to get back out as this fruit sets and starts to size up to continue to track that as we come into kind of thinning time. Hey, Manon.
Manon comes in, it's a white. We're not sure of its winter hardiness because we get very mixed reviews depending on where it's located. But the variety itself came out of France.
Yeah, and I think this year we were a little bit light on this one. We did see a little bit of winter damage, but we'll continue to track it seasons going forward. Again, we're right in that range of May 5th for full bloom. July Rose.
July Rose is an early white peach that matures about 7 days ahead of Red Haven. I like it better than Scarlet Rose. It'll be interesting to see how it performs in New Hampshire, but we really like it down here. It's a Rutgers selection, and it has high tolerance to backspot.
Are all the roses from the same Rutgers selection? Tom, if you came through, there's several different rose varieties. Are they all?
Yes. Yes, they are. Yes. Yes. Yeah, all the rose series are out of Rutgers. Yes.
This one was a little later for us. You know, at April 28th, we were still at swollen bud. And then we got some warmer temps coming up and everything, you know, including apples, just really pushed out quickly. From that point forward, but it was holding tight for a while there, and then seemed to really, you know, it's about a week behind everything else, it seemed like, coming into full bloom. Okay, Scarlet Rose.
Scarlet Rose is, again, a white selection out of Rutgers. It's seasoned, it begins about 3 days ahead of Red Haven and picks up into White Lady. Fruit set as far as hardiness is rather unknown at this point. It's done well down here, but how well it will do New Hampshire is yet to be seen.
Yeah, so it's interesting to hear. And we did this year get some significant bud kill on it. So we were a little bit later, about a week later for full bloom, almost the 12th of May on this one. And so it did get take a bit of a hit this year, but we'll see how it does in years going forward. Okay, then here we're at White Lady.
White Lady is one of our oldest white selections out of the Zeiger. It's a wonderful California peach. It's been around in New England for over 20 years. Usually it has extremely good bud hardiness, and it's rather subacid in flavor, but it'll hang on the tree for a good 10 to 12 days.
We actually, it looks like we've got the tag mixed up in this one, but for White Lady, my notes are showing, you know, we were pink at 428, full bloom again on May 5th. And that we had a nice solid bloom and good bud survival this season. So, again, looking forward to this one. This is one of the ones that I've kind of put a star beside this year that looked really promising, and I'm excited to see as this fruit starts to size up and eventually ripen here this season.
One of the things I would look at, Jeremy, which is interesting to look at the growth habit. A lot of your white selections have more of an upright growth habit, and White Lady's one of them.
Certainly see that. So we'll keep an eye on that and try to keep them opened up. Okay, Sugar Giant.
Sugar Giant's been around for a long time. Again, it's extremely bud hardy. Season is 20 days after Red Haven. It'll hang on the tree for up to 7 to 10 days, and it's considered subacid white. Again, it has an upright growth habit.
Yeah, and for us, it was interesting because, again, I think these trees have grown really well for us. You know, we've been able to get a nice shape out of them for the most part. We're still right around that 5-5 bloom date. Our bloom was a little bit lighter. We did have a little winter kill, but we ended up with a pretty decent fruit set. So this is another one that I'm excited to see going forward, how it shapes up for us. August Rose.
August Rose, I would call my favorite peach of the season. The fruit itself does have somewhat of a rose aroma to it. It's picked about 25 days after Red Haven. I'm unsure as far as the winter hardiness in the Massachusetts and New Hampshire. I hope it does as well for you because we love this peach.
Listening to you describe it, Tom, I hope it does well for us too. you know, it sounds like a good peach in your area, and it'll be interesting to see, you know, if we can pull this through. This year we did get some damage on it, but you know, I mean, I think looking at this trial, you know, another couple of years down the line where we've got a good 3 years or so of at least of fruiting, you know, and get a little bit better idea on average, you know, how often these trees pull through, I'm looking forward to seeing that. So just want to say I'm not ruling any of these out at this point, but you know, just looking forward to kind of how often, you know, we're able to pull a crop through on them. Desiree
is one of our earliest commercial peaches. It's a yellow peach that picks about 26 days ahead of Red Haven. It has incredible fruit size for its season and has shown good winter hardiness in a lot of the peach growing districts. So I'm anxious to see how well it does up in New Hampshire, but it has been good in other areas.
The days to harvest is based on Red Haven. I took from the Michigan State website. They have an excellent website saying how many days before or after Red Haven. So that information was available for the yellow peaches, but they didn't have that information for the other peaches, why we didn't have it on there.
Right. And I think it's also in our catalog.
So we were around the 8th of May, so just slightly later than many of the varieties, by 3 days or so. Kind of a light bloom this year on this variety for us. And, you know, we had relatively poor bud survival from the notes I took, comparatively to some of the other varieties this season. PF5D, Big Flame and Fury.
5D has been a nice peach. It was a big improvement over the original 5B, but bud hardiness I'm unsure of. It's a good early peach. It follows Desiree. It's for the season, it has great fruit size and doesn't have a lot of split pits, but we're curious to see how it performs up there, Jeremy.
Yeah, I am too, because, you know, comparing it to some of the other PF varieties, you know, some of those did really well for us, I feel like, this season. But this one this year, we got pretty significant bud kill on. We're around the 12th of May for full bloom. You know, just it's nice to have more than one of these varieties or several of them in the trial so we can compare them, because some are certainly doing better for us than others are. So appreciate being able to have a variety, a selection of them in our trial. Langlo?
I hope this variety does as well in New England as it does in our area. Glenglow has shown excellent spring survival through spring freezes. It's actually a sport of Crest Haven, and it picks about 2 weeks ahead of Red Haven. Looks to me like the trees are lagging in size, so I think you better wait another year or two to assess the bud injury.
Yeah, absolutely. You know what, Tom? This is the variety that was set later. So this is the one that we couldn't get in year one.
Uh-huh.
So we set these a year later. So that's part of what's going on with these guys. And so, yeah, they didn't really get a full shake at it this year. Okay, so we're at TF 9A007.
Sure, 9A, Jeremy is, was looked at as a possible replacement for Red Haven. However, I'm concerned about its bud hardiness. I think we'll get a good test in your neck of the woods. It's more freestone than Red Haven on first pick, and the quality's there, but I think it's more tender than Red Haven. Red Haven just isn't going to go away.
Yeah. Yeah, and I don't think we really, you know, learned a whole lot about this variety this year. You know, I think bud survival was okay. Fruit set maybe a little on the light side this year, but, you know, we'll keep following it for the next couple of years. See what we can see with this one. Okay, here's Red Haven.
Red Haven still is the standard, and it amazes me the number of Red Haven trees that we sell every year. It's just not, we haven't found a peach to totally replace it, Jeremy. So it's a good standard to have in your block.
Yeah, I have to agree, you know, from what I've seen with the varieties that are out here, you know, this, as far as hardiness and, you know, bloom and, you know, bud survival, and now moving into fruit set, you know, it's been right there at the top with any of them. And so it's a nice one to be able to compare others to, and I can see why it remains the standard for sure. It's doing well for us this year.
And it's an easier tree to prune. It's easy to get that open vase compared to some of the other varieties.
So here's Evelyn.
Evelyn is one of my favorite peaches. It's actually in the Red Haven season. It's out of Rutgers. I hope this variety does as well up there as it's done down here. It's shown good bud set, good bud hardiness. The only thing about it is it does not have the traditional acid flavor. It's a sub-acid piece of fruit.
Yeah, and we've certainly noticed, you know, it's got a nice open habit for us, you know, so we'll see what it looks like going forward and as fruit starts to ripen, but it's another one that I'm really interested in. It seems like, you know, an easy tree to grow, and, you know, for two out of the three, we've gotten really great growth, and we're starting to get a nice tree structure out of those. So I'm excited to see this one, and I hope, you know, the bud survival is there, and you know, looking forward to assessing fruit quality a little bit as we go on. So here's just a photo of that tree in bloom. You know, nice open, good branch angles. Really like the way this tree likes to grow. Okay, Starfire.
Starfire, I think, will do very good in New England. It's one of the peaches out of the Stellar breeding program in Michigan, the Friday series. And it has shown very good bud hardiness, and the fruit quality is pretty good. It would be in second picking Red Haven season.
And we saw, you know, again, we're right around that 5-5 full bloom date, and we do have good fruit set. We have good bud survival. You know, a good bloom, and now we have a nice crop set on that tree. So looking forward to following this as we go along. Some of these trees were a little smaller, but they're also on the very end row, so that may have something to do with that as well. You know, those very end trees are slightly smaller than those moving back up the row. So
you took the words out of my mouth, Jeremy. I was going to jump in and said this is at the end of the road, so it's getting that morning shading, it doesn't get that good morning sunlight, so they're not going to grow as well. So I wouldn't hold that against this variety.
And we're looking forward to kind of continuing to develop tree structure on these. We realize we've got a little bit of work to do on some of them, but we're looking forward to good growth this year and really shaping them up going into their fourth season. Okay, John Boy.
John Boy has been one of our signature peaches. It's a sport of luring and has shown very good fruit set over the years for us. And it has done well in Massachusetts. So I think John Boy is still a winner. It's considered second picking Red Haven, it's freestone right off the bat, and it's a very firm peach. It hangs on the tree quite well.
One of the things I've liked with this one is it tends to have a nice open spreading habit, so I think it seems like an easy grower. We've gotten good growth, kind of pretty uniform across the trees for the most part from what we have. So, you know, a little bit earlier on full bloom date by 3 days or so. We're looking forward to following this one as well, but it seems like a nice tree to grow. All right, we're at PF 17.
PF 17 is a nice peach to pick between John Boy and Coral Star. It has shown excellent bud hardiness. It's a large piece of fruit. But one of the things I would notice about is the growth habit of that tree. It is somewhat upright.
Yep, definitely. Yep. And of the Friday varieties that we included, this is one of the ones that has done better for us this year as far as bud hardiness, bloom, and then eventually fruit set. So this is one that I'm kind of excited for and looking forward to following it, hoping it continues this trend through the next couple of seasons. So right now, it's looking pretty good for us.
I think it's going to do really good up there, Jeremy.
I'm excited for it. And then we're at Contender.
It'll be interesting to see what your bloom date is on Contender. In most areas, usually the bloom on Contender is 10 days to 2 weeks after the other varieties.
Yeah.
It's extremely bud hardy. And I've seen Contender trees grow where peaches shouldn't be grown.
So we did see that. We're at around the 12th of May of this year for full bloom. And Chuck's foot for us was around the 26th and did have a good set for sure this year. So, you know, it's doing really well for us and seems like another one of those kind of baseline, you know, staple varieties that, you know, if it fits in date wise for what growers are looking for, at least so far from what we're seeing, this has pulled through the winter pretty well.
One thing about Contender is it's not really designed to be a large peach. It's more of a medium-sized peach, and I think it's because it sets up so heavy. It sets up like a Red Haven.
Yeah.
And, you know, Red Havens you have to aggressively thin to get fruit size, and Contender is the same situation.
Yep, that's certainly what we've seen.
Disease-wise, Tom, what do you see with Contender?
It's been really good, George. It doesn't see any back spot, and Contender's been one of those varieties that if you don't have a crop of Contender, you don't have a crop of peaches.
Okay, here it was for us in bloom this year. Ended up again, like I was saying, really good fruit set out of that, with, you know, several peaches per shoot for sure. So a fair amount of thinning to be done there. Okay,
right,
we're getting towards the end here. We're at Coral Star.
Coral Star is, again, one of the Friday selections out of Michigan, and it's probably one of the easiest peaches to grow. The tree usually has a good shape to it. Fruit quality is good. It's considered mid-season for us. You know, we pick it usually here the middle of August, so it's probably going to be the end of August for you.
Yep, and this one we were a little later in full bloom, around the 15th, so mid-May on this one. We got a good set, and we actually had lots of doubles, you know, where both of those fruit, you know, set side by side. So it seems like, again, one that may need some significant thinning going forward. Okay, Messina.
Messina's kind of has fooled us. Initially, we thought it was with Crest Haven season, but all the growers that have it in the ground seem to think it matures more like a week ahead of Crest Haven. I think this variety might be a little tender at times for New England. It's not as hardy as Crest Haven, but it's a beautiful piece of fruit.
Yep, I bet you're right, Tom. I mean, what we saw this year anyway was, you know, there was some fruit there. We did have some buds pull through and you know, I'd say a light bloom. But the fruit that did set, it was pretty sporadic on those branches and fairly spaced out. So interesting to see going forward another couple of years and see if that trend holds true. Okay.
PF23 has been around a long time, and I recommended this to Gwen to your trial because it's a rather bud hardy piece of fruit, and it's something to pick a week after the contender or coral star season, yet before Cresthaven. One thing that I would advise on this variety is that don't pick it when it's early, but if you allow it to sit for a week or so, you'll gain it. You know, another half inch in size, so it'll fool you on harvest.
Okay, so give it a little extra time. Okay, and we did have a good set on this year, so we will certainly give that recommendation a shot as we start to come into harvest season on that one. So excited to see this. Between this and 17, you know, those are the two of the PF varieties for us this year that seem to do well and come through the winter in pretty good shape. So, you know, I don't know if other growers are seeing the same or if they're trying these, but for us it was 17 and 23. Cresthaven?
Well, we put Cresthaven in the study because it's an old standard, but it's still a good peach. One negative thing about Cresthaven trees is they tend to crop themselves out, so they're a rather short-lived tree. And one of the things that you can combat in keeping the tree alive longer is multiple applications of fertilizer with this variety. It should have split application, you know, one early spring and another one in June or late June.
Okay. For us, we were around the 12th of May for full bloom. Set split was around the 26th. And yeah, we have a decent crop on there, a little lighter than other varieties that were in the trial, but certainly some fruit, so excited to follow that as it goes, sizes up, and kind of compare some of that flavor and take some notes on harvest dates as well. So that's something I look forward to pulling together as part of this trial as we continue through this season and the next couple of seasons. Selena?
I think Selena will be the last peach that you probably want to harvest up there. We really like, it's a Rucker selection, and we really like its hardiness, and it's excellent fruit size. And a lot of times on late varieties, you'll see a great amount of fruit drop, and that's one characteristic of this New Jersey selection, is it doesn't drop, and it would be considered encore season.
Okay, so we were around the 8th of May for full bloom here, and for us, you know, we had decent bud survival, I would say, this year, but we definitely did notice some damage and some winter kill, so interesting to see whether or not that continues seasons going forward. In bloom, you can kind of see some of these shoots closer to the bottom of the screen where, you know, there would have been some bud damage here, and then as we get in, we have a little survival, but you'll see sporadic bloom survival. Some of these shoots here for us this year. Okay, and that is